What's up, everybody? It's Lil Hootie here, and we're going to ask you guys some questions about some patriotism. Let's go. So, how many stars are on the American flag?
I don't know.
How many stars are on the American flag, Allie? No, you have to say it in the mic.
50.
And who is our 16th president?
Oh, I don't know.
So we've got Zion Pfeiffer, number 29, for the Tigers. Yeah. How many stars are on the American flag?
50.
How many stripes?
11.
Who's our 16th president?
Abraham Lincoln.
How many stars are on the American flag?
50.
How many stripes?
60.
Sit! How many stars are on the American flag?
50.
How many stripes?
I don't know.
How many stars are on the American flag, Dyson?
50.
How many stripes?
13.
Who was our 16th president?
I don't know.
How many stars are on the American flag?
50.
Hey, no, you guys can't peek around the corner and not expect to be on accent. Who's the 16th president?
Abraham Lincoln.
Wrong.
Yes, it is. That is right.
Check it. How many stars are on the American flag?
How many stars on the American flag? That's a good question. I say 50.
How many stars are on the American flag, dog?
Like 50 or something like that.
How many stripes?
13.
I'm right, ain't I?
Who's our 16th president?
Abe Lincoln.
How many stars are on the American flag?
49.
Who's our 16th president, Jay Broad?
Barack Obama.
The kick goes to Tyree Broyles. She's going to receive it around the 10-yard line. Burst straight up the middle. He's getting to the 50, the 40, the 30, the 20, the 10. Touchdown, Tiger!
Wow, the Tigers played a really good game last week.
Mm-hmm.
I really hope they win tonight.
Me too.
Hi, and welcome to Your Accent for Friday, November 10th. I'm Kira Sheely, here with Maddie Mummy. Let's get it started.
The Drama Club is proud to present Long Ago and Far Away, three short plays that will make you laugh and send a chill up your spine. Tickets are just $3, and there's only one performance remaining. Be sure to see the fall play tonight at 7 p.m. in the WHS Auditorium.
The next Success Club meeting is this Monday, November 13th, right after school in C101. All members should plan on attending. Any new members are welcome as well.
To all staff and students, the junior class will be having a fundraising night at Buffalo Wild Wings next Wednesday, November 15th. They will have a basket raffle as well. Please come out and support them as they try to raise money for the prom of 2019. Thanks for your support.
Thanks to Mrs. Smith-Heisler for sharing her story and for her service to our country. And thanks to Ms. Palmer and her students for their efforts in producing this important segment.
Hi, I'm Jen Smith-Heisler. I graduated from Washington High School in 1999. I am currently the assistant band director here and have been for the last 13 years. I was a member of the Air Force National Guard for 11 years from the year 2000 to 2011. I decided to serve in the Air Force because I had always had an interest in the military, especially in military bands. When I was graduating high school, I contemplated auditioning and trying out, but I ultimately didn't. And then an opportunity came up later, and I was lucky enough to be in the right place at the right time and win the audition. There are a lot of things that I learned in the military that still impact me today. Probably one of the most important is just simply the core values of the Air Force, and that's integrity first, service before self, and excellence in all you do. My specialty in the Air Force was I was a musician. I was a trombonist and a vocalist. I was also the announcer for the Air National Guard Band of the Great Lakes, the 555th, based in Toledo, Ohio. As a guardsman, the challenges I faced were different from a lot of the active duty Air Force. For me personally, the challenges I faced were having a civilian career that's very busy, along with having a family, and just splitting time and finding a good life balance with all of that. The advice that I would have for people considering joining the armed forces would just be to do your homework and make sure that you know what branch you would like to get into and know what your opportunities are within that branch or within all of the different armed forces. My other advice, on a little more lighthearted note, make sure you're in good physical shape before you go to basic training or you're going to have quite the shock to your system. And lastly, I would just say thank you for your willingness to serve in this day and age where you have countless opportunities and other options. There are a lot of benefits that go along with being a member of the armed forces. As a guardsman, my biggest benefit was the educational benefit. I was actually able to do my last 2 years of college at a state school at Bowling Green State University for free because of the educational benefit I received from the Air National Guard. Today's society, rather than trying to gain more benefits, right now the more concerning part is I often see veterans' benefits being cut or legislation being brought up that would cut benefits, and that is a mistake. These people have served our country, and they have held up their end of the bargain. We need to make sure that as a country and as a people, we are holding up our end of the bargain. Veterans Day to me is very important because it's a time for us to show our gratitude to all of those who have served. I know, especially being a bandsman, I often got a chance to say thank you to some of those older veterans that served our country and maybe times where they were not said thank you to. I know that I had at some of our concerts, we would have Vietnam veterans who came home feeling very unappreciated and in fact even feeling almost like they were the enemy in a society that just was in upheaval. And I'm always grateful to them, and I always like to say thank you to all the veterans who have served and sacrificed for us and for our greater good.
Ever think about running indoor track? Check this out.
When you get to the edge, your brain will always tell you to step back. It's always gonna tell you to step back. Because you can fall, always. It's gonna tell you to step back. Because before you fail, the last time you did this, you saw someone else fail, you could hurt, you could be off work. It's gonna tell you, it's designed to keep you safe. So you have to be willing to play between your brain and your soul. And on some days, you gotta just listen to your soul. And you gotta say, I'm gonna leap, I'm gonna get to the edge. Most people are at the edge, and you're standing at the edge, and you're watching everyone else fly, wondering what it's gonna be like when you jump without ever jumping. And I'm just here to tell you, jump. Because only three things can happen. You're either gonna jump and fly, or you're gonna jump and fall on something soft, or you're gonna fall down hard. Either way, you're gonna get back up. You already know you got what it takes to get back up. Your greatest fear is not that you will fall. Your greatest fear is that you will live a full life and never fly, that you never leaped. You're not afraid of dying. You're afraid of dying before the world sees who you really are.
There will be a mandatory meeting for all athletes looking forward to competing in indoor track this winter. The indoor track meeting will be this Monday, November 13th, after school in room C101. If you have questions, see Coach Scott.
Today's lunch is a quesadilla, black beans, salsa, buttered corn, and fruit.
Happy birthday to Haley Brunker, Katie Conger, and Michaela Toomey. That's all for your accent. I'm Maddie, here with Kira. We'll see you Monday.